इनिशिएटिव्स, द प्लानिंग कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया ऑप्टेड फॉर 5 ईयर प्लान्स, दो द आइडिया वॉज वेरी सिंपल, द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया प्रिपेयर्स अ डॉक्यूमेंट दैट हैज अ प्लान फॉर ऑल इट्स इनकम एंड एक्सपेंडिचर्स फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 ईयर. अकॉर्डिंगली द बजट ऑफ द सेंट्रल एंड ऑल द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट इज डिवाइडेड इन टू द टू पार्ट्स. नंबर वन नॉन प्लान बजट. नॉन प्लान बजट मीन्स इट इज स्पेंट ऑन द रूटीन आइटम्स ऑन अ ईयरली बेसिस एंड प्लान बजट दैट इज स्पेंड ऑन द 5 ईयर बेसिस एज पर द प्रायोरिटीज फिक्स्ड बाय द प्लान. हैव यू गेट इट? हैव यू गेट इट? एज पर द बजट ऑफ द सेंट्रल एंड ऑल द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स इट इज डिवाइडेड इन टू द टू पार्ट्स. फर्स्ट इज द First, first is known as the non-plan budget, which is spent on the routine items on a yearly basis, on the annual basis, and a plan budget that is spent on the 5 year basis as per the priorities fixed by the plan. Secondly, a 5 year plan has the advantage of permitting the government to focus on the larger picture and make long-term intervention into the economy. So the draft of the first 5 year plan and then the actual plan document released in December 1951, and this first 5 year plan generated a lot of excitement in the country. People from all walks of life, either the academics, journalists, government, private sector employees, industrialists, farmers, politicians, all of them discussed and debated the documents extensively. And this excitement with planning reached its peak with the launching of the second 5 year plan in 1956 and continued till the third 5 year plan in 1961. Then the fourth plan was due to start in 1966. By this time, the novelty of planning had declined considerably, and moreover, India was facing acute economic crisis. The government decided to take a plan holiday. This was the time when we had a Indo-China war in 1962, and we had a Indo-Pakistan war in 1965. And thirdly, political instability had been there. We had lost our two prime ministers during 1960s, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Lal Bahadur Shastri. We had lost them. So due to all these, what happened? We had to introduce some plan holidays during 1960s. So now we come on next, the first 5 year plans. The first 5 year plans, we have already covered it in the previous video. So please go through that. I had discussed it, mainly focused on the land reforms, focused on the primary sector mainly, and agriculture was the main focus. Second 5 year plans also we had discussed over there. Third, fourth 5 year plans we had discussed. We had discussed even this data given in the NCERT. You must know how to study all these diagrams we have discussed. Please go through that and listen it attentively. Next, we were on the problems. What were the problems associated with that of the 5 year plans? What happened? The Indian planners, number one, the Indian planners found balancing industry and agriculture. It was quite difficult for them. Reason was they got confused which one should attract more public resources in a backward economy like India. Many of them thought that the second plan lacked an agrarian strategy for the development, and the emphasis on industry caused agriculture and rural India to suffer. Gandhian economists like J.C. Kumarappa proposed an alternative blueprint that put a greater emphasis on rural industrialization. Hua J.C. Kumarappa? He was an economist, a chartered accountant. He studied in England and the USA. He was the follower of Mahatma Gandhi. He tried to apply Gandhian principles to economic policies. He is the author of Economy of Permanence, participated in planning process
Yes,
as a
sir.
member of the planning commission. On the other hand, Chaudhary Charan Singh, a Congress leader who later broke from the party to form Bharatiya Lok Dal, forcefully articulated the case for keeping agriculture at the center of planning for India. He said that the planning was leading to creation of prosperity in urban areas only and industrial section at the expense of the farmers and the rural population. Chaudhary Charan Singh claimed that whatsoever the development is taking place in the name of industries, in the name of urbanization, all these are being done at the cost of the farmers and the rural population only. Hence, always the agriculture must be the central idea behind the planning. So this is known as the urban bias. Other thoughts that without a drastic increase in industrial production, there could be no escape from the cycle of poverty. Other thought, if industries had not been given the priority over agriculture, how could the country develop? How will we come out of the vicious cycle of poverty? Okay, how will the employments be generated into the economy? Okay. They argued that Indian planning did have an agrarian strategy to boost the production of food grains. The state made laws for land reforms and distribution of resources among the poor in the villages. It also proposed programs of community development and spent large sums of irrigation projects. The failure was not that of policy, but its non-implementation because the land-owning classes had a lot of social and political powers. Besides, they also argue that even if the government had spent more money on agriculture, it would not have solved the massive problem of the rural poverty. So all these were the problems at the time of the 5-year plans. I hope all of you have got it. Except
Yes,
this,
ma'am.
some problems were also there. This was the problem of here we would like to discuss one more controversy. One more controversy had been there. Public versus private sector. Public sector versus the private sector. What happened? India did not accept the capitalist model of development in which development was left entirely to the private sector, nor did it follow the socialist model in which private property was abolished and all the production was controlled by the states. So elements from both these models were taken and mixed it together in India. That is why it is described as the mixed economy. We have already discussed the concept of mixed economy. So in this, much of the agriculture, trade, and industry, these were left into the private hands. State controlled the heavy industries and it provided the industrial infrastructure. It regulated trade and made some crucial interventions in agriculture. Got it?
Yes,
Got it,
ma'am.
everyone? Say something, yes or no? You
Yes,
have
ma'am.
any queries? Anyone? Yes, Ayan?
Ma'am, till not.
Till not
Ma'am,
means
after
anything.
reading, I will say, ma'am.
Okay, very good. So now we come on the next Kerala model. Before we discuss the Kerala model, we would like to discuss something with you. I have to discuss. So please just give me 2 seconds only. I open the PDF. Could you see 5-year plans of India in details?
Yes, ma'am, you can see.
Everyone could see. What could you see on the screen? 5-year plans of India in details?
Ma'am,
yes,
first plan, second plan, and the third plan.
Very good, very good. You could see first plan 1951 to 56. So
yes, ma'am.
Before we go ahead in the chapter, we would like to discuss all these 5-year plans, and obviously as usual I had given you the activities, so this is also the part of your activities. You have to prepare the chart on all the 5-year plans of India like this. You have to cover up only the main headings. Okay, so number one,
okay.
First of all we'll discuss just wait, I have to see. Yes, first plan. Okay, we'll go one by one. We'll discuss all the 5-year plans in short, so that you could prepare the notes also on all the 5-year plans. First plan, 1951 to 56. Okay, it was based on the Harrod-Domer model. During this time, Bhakra Nangal, Hirakund, and Mettur Dam were started. 5 Indian Institutes of Technology were also started, and at this time community development projects were also started, which we have already discussed in details. Okay, in the first plan, the targeted growth was 2.1%. Okay, this was 2.1%, but we achieved 3.6% of growth in the first 5-year plans. After that, we come on the second 5-year plan. This is the second 5-year plan. The period is from 1956 to 61. Okay. The targeted growth was 4.5%. You could see here. And we achieved 4.27% in the second 5-year plans. It was based on the Mahalanobis model. About PC Mahalanobis, we have already discussed in the previous video. We have talked in detail about him. And at this time, domestic production of industrial products and rapid industrialization took place. The achievements were, we established the steel plants at Bhilai, USSR, Durgapur, UK, Rourkela, West Germany. Okay, these were the steel plants. And after that we come on the third plan. Third plan, as we have already discussed, third plan took place from 1961 to 66. At this time, Gadgil Yojana took place, and the targeted growth was 5.6%, and we achieved 2.4%. At this time, we had the wars with China in 1962 and war with Pakistan in 1965. So this was the period after the third plan. We had the 3 annual plan holidays from in between 1966 to 1969. So during all these annual plans, we focused on the equal priority to agriculture, its elite activities, and industrial sector. 4 to 5 year plans took place from 1969 to 1974. This we could see. Here again, the targeted growth was 5.6%, but we could achieve only 3.3%. At this time, this was the time when Shrimati Indira Gandhi had been our prime minister. At this time, the Green Revolution took place. 14 major banks were nationalized in 1969. And Smiling Buddha underground nuclear test, Pokhran test in Rajasthan in 1974. All these took place during the 4th 5-year plan. 5th 5-year plans. The period was from 1974 to 78. Targeted growth was 4.4%, and we achieved 4.8% approx. It focused mainly on the poverty alleviation, self-reliance in agricultural and defense, and national highway system. And it introduced the minimum needs program, MNP. MNP we discussed in class 11th in some of the chapter. At this time, 20-point program was also launched in 1975. Integrated Urban Development Program was also launched, and it was prepared by D.P. Dhar. What happened after 5th 5-year plan, 1974 to 78, we had to introduce some rolling plans. So what do we mean by rolling plan? Perhaps rolling plan I had already told you in the video also. Okay, just go through that. What are the rolling plans? Okay. Janata Party government rejected the 5th 5-year plan. Rolling plan concept was coined by Gunnar Myrdal. It was Integrated Rural Development Program, which is popularly known as IRDP. Next, we come 6th 5-year plan from 1980 to 1985. And this was the beginning of the economic liberalization. Price controls were eliminated. And NABARD was established in 1982. Family planning took place in the 6th 5-year plan. And National Rural Employment Program in 1980, it was also introduced. Now we come on the 7th 5-year plan. It took place from 1985 to 1990. Okay. And targeted growth, all of you are looking at the targeted growth also, no? Perhaps I forgot and no one asked to me. I forgot to discuss in the 6th plan, targeted growth was 5.2% and it was achieved 5.4%. So this is not important for you, okay, ki targeted and achieved, but you can mention this in your activity, please. Now we come on the 7th 5-year plan. This was the period from 1985 to 1990. It targeted on 5% growth, but it could achieve only 6.1% growth. The main growth, modernization, self-reliance and social justice. First time private sector got the priority over public sector. Jawahar Rozgar Yojana was launched in 1989. Annual plans. Again, the annual plans were introduced after 7th 5-year plan. These were the annual plans from 1990 to 1991 and 1991 to 1992. At that time, balance of payment crisis took place, and LPG reforms, liberalization, privatization and globalization, these were introduced. All these will discuss in economics. Who are from economics, they could understand it well. This is the separate chapter in our economics. So now we come on the 8th 5-year plans. This was the period from 1992 to 1997. Targeted growth was 5.6% and we achieved 6.8%. During 8th 5-year plan, lower emphasis on heavy industries and more on infrastructure. Objectives were modernization of industries and employment generation. Member of Parliament Local Area Development Scheme was introduced at the time of 8th 5-year plans. Now we come on the 9th 5-year plans. The period of the 9th 5-year plans is from 1997 to 2002. Please note it down. It's hidden here. Please note down from 1997 to 2002. Targeted growth was 7% and we could achieve only 5.6%. At this time, the main focus was on basic minimum services, priority to agriculture and rural development, and the concept of growth with justice and equity, ensuring food and nutritional security for all. Focus on reduction in the revenue deficit and decentralization of planning. Here, this is the revenue deficit. Focus on reduction in the revenue deficit. Please note it down. 10th 5-year plan, now we come. the period of the 10th 5-year plan was from 2002 to 2007. Targeted growth was 8%, and we could achieve only 7.2%. The focus were on doubling per capita income in 10 years. Agriculture sector declared as the prime moving force of economy. Reduction in general gaps in literacy. Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act 2005 was introduced in the 10th 5-year plan. ठीक है, व्हाटसोएवर हैज बीन मेंशन इन बोर्ड, सो यू हैव टू लर्न स्पेशली दैट. ठीक है, यू हैव टू लर्न दैट स्पेशली व्हाटसोएवर हैज बीन रिटन इन बोल्ड लेटर्स. नाउ वी कम ऑन द 11th 5-year प्लान. इन वन आई लास्क यू लेटर ऑन 11th 5-year plans were from 2007 to 2012. Its targeted growth was 8.1% and it achieved only 7.9%. This plan targets a growth rate of 10%, emphasizes the idea of inclusive growth, increased forest and tree cover, national food security mission. A higher inflation was the main problem at this time during the 11th 5-year plans. Now we come on the 12th 5-year plans. This was the period from 2012 to 2017. Target was 9%, but we achieved only 8%. It focused on growth faster, inclusive and sustainable. Aadhaar based direct cash transfer scheme was introduced at that time. Here I had left something, the rolling plan. Okay, now I would like to let you know what is the rolling plan. This is here. Rolling plan took place after the 5th 5-year plans. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So what were the rolling plans? Rolling plans are, write it down. I'm just speaking. Please write down. Rolling plan is the plan where there is no fixation of dates in respect of commencement, and end of the plan. And end of the plan. It would depend on the circumstances, in fact. The main advantage is that they are flexible and are able to overcome the rigidity and are able to overcome the rigidity by mending targets and the objectives. The main advantage is that they are flexible and are able to overcome the rigidity by mending targets and the objectives. I'll send you on WhatsApp also. Okay, I'll just click the
Okay,
and I'll just share on WhatsApp also. And plan holidays. I hope everyone had written down. Write down the plan holidays also. No five-year plan could be made due to some unavoidable reasons. Hence, annual plans were drawn. I hope the things are clear to each and everyone. Now we come.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, now all of you just let me know which 5-year plans are going on at present. You just tell me. Yes, who can tell? Let's see.
मैम
यस 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 स्पीक अप, दिस इज
मैम
13th 5 year plan.
मैम आफ्टर 1947
अरे बेटा, आई एम वी आर जस्ट टॉकिंग 12th 5 year प्लान. वी आर गोइंग ऑन फ्रॉम
यस मैम
2012 टू 2017. ओके, नाउ इट
यस
मींस
मैम यस मैम
13th 5 year प्लान्स आर गोइंग ऑन फ्रॉम 2017 टू
17 टू
20
हाँ तो यहाँ पे
2000
ट्वेंटी
2022.
22 यस मैम यस मैम
यस, ओके, सो दिस टाइम 13th 5 year प्लान्स आर गोइंग ऑन एंड द ड्यूरेशन इज फ्रॉम 2017 टू 2022. सो
यस
व्हाट
मैम
आर द 13th 5 year प्लान्स? बेसिकली इट इज नोन एज द डिफेंस प्लान. दिस इज बेसिकली नोन एज द डिफेंस प्लान.
डिफेंस
आई जस्ट
प्लान
राइट इट हियर, है ना. 13th 5 year प्लान्स आर डिफेंस प्लान. जस्ट टू वेट, आई जस्ट राइट इट हियर. राइट डाउन 13th 5 year प्लान्स पीरियड फ्रॉम 2017 टू 2022 एंड दिस टाइम 13th 5 year प्लान्स आर गोइंग ऑन. दीज आर नोन एज द डिफेंस प्लान ऑल्सो. राइट डाउन प्लीज, दीज आर नोन एज द डिफेंस प्लान ऑल्सो एंड इट एनविजेस एंड इट एनविजेस. एवरी वन नोज द स्पेलिंग ऑफ एनविजेस. इट इज
यस मैम NENVISA GES
वेरी गुड. एनविजेस, वेरी गुड. एवरी वन हैज हर्ड, सो प्लीज राइट इट डाउन. Envisages an allocation of rupees of rupees 26 lakh crore. 26 lakh crore 83,924. Crores for the armed forces. For the armed forces. And the main objective of the 13th 5 year plans and the main objective of the 13th 5 year plans are maintaining economic growth, maintaining economic growth, transforming economic development, and accelerating modernization in agriculture, etc. Okay, so this time 13th 5 year plans are going on. Please keep it. Remember, I hope the things are
okay.
Clear.
Yes ma'am.
Any problem to anyone? I could hear only single
no, ma'am.
voice. What about the others? Everyone could hear to me?
Yes ma'am.
Very good.